The year is 2030, and internet access is no longer a basic right, but instead a biometrically enabled privilege that's now carefully regulated by global powers. After a mysterious but catastrophic worldwide digital attack was purportedly paid for in cash by untraceable online masterminds, governments created identity guardrails to prevent further attacks. This is precisely why now no one is permitted to buy, sell, or even access data without first providing their connecting device with their biometric data, such as their iris scan or their thumbprint, in order to verify their internet ID and carefully track all subsequent online activity. Plus, because everything that moves is now automated by artificial intelligence, any ability to interface with these intelligent devices also requires authentication with an internet usage token. This token is given upon the user validating their biometric data, which then logs into all of their online accounts without remembering passwords and even bank cards for purchases online. In fact, central banks now issue digital equivalents to replace their recalled cash currencies, which were deemed unsafe for being most likely to finance illicit activities. These central bank digital currencies automatically track all of a citizen's transactions, while automating taxes, fines, fees, freezes, and other safety features in order to protect users from potentially dangerous situations. And thanks to AI, suspicious transactions are automatically blocked by the world's central bank digital currencies to prevent users from unwittingly transferring funds to third parties that may have criminal purchase profiles, malicious income sources, or other suspect digital ties. In fact, these systems are so safe that if purchase or spending behaviors cross into suspicious territory, the ability to spend, transfer, or even accept future income will all be suspended. This freeze can not only disable a user's ability to transact in the world economy, but can even extend to preventing further online access tokens to this specific user, in turn, not just cutting them off from the world's financial network, but the wider internet. Furthermore, because all devices are internet connected, when AI detects anomalous usage or dangerous behavior, it's relatively easy to segregate bad actors from common services. This world security system built on the new paradigm of safety via CBDCs even turns into a new age credit rating system as agencies across borders are able to quickly share and compare data. The result is a global credit, currency, and communication standard that is intermediated by each country's government or central bank's digital currencies. It also becomes illegal to use various forms of encryption and digital cash as unbreakable data encryption methods are declared to be grave threats to global security. But this is only the beginning of the security measures to be set in place as governments work feverishly to protect their citizens. That's because by this time, the metaverse is now the prevailing online medium, as traditional browser-based internet usage is steadily becoming less prevalent. This new internet experience is not just three-dimensional, but also sensory input-based, meaning that participants can make use of tactile feedback when interacting with different environments. This adds a whole new range of remote jobs to the human economy, with many of them being remote control imitation learning-based workflows that train machines to perform human tasks by example. In fact, most humans rely on working in the metaverse more than working in the real world, as most jobs are executed via remote operation. And as the online everything approach becomes increasingly ubiquitous in the world economy, brain-computer interface begins to replace the use of keyboard and mouse, opening up a whole new range of interactive capabilities with computers, and also security vulnerabilities. To address these, brain-computer interface becomes highly regulated by government agencies to provide backdoor access to both hardware and software. This allows governments to largely monitor, influence, and even somewhat control the thought processes of most of their citizens for their safety. Plus, because any dissenting opinions, language, or ideas can be automatically censored and blocked by government filters, all online users are insulated from dangerous ideas that don't conform to the status quo. And on top of transforming money and internet access, this also drastically changes the future of how income is dispersed, as universal basic income gets redistributed according to a whole new paradigm of human value creation. This new paradigm of value creation is based on the amount and usefulness of the data produced by any human, directly or indirectly. This means that both creating original content online for AIs and robots to train on, as well as causing other internet users to create their own data, will both be credited to one's digital footprint as some form of financial gain. As a result, contributors of any format of original data will be paid according to their outputs and the resulting engagement, with the value of these outputs being rated to influence the user's overall online profile, history, credit, account balance, permissions, and so forth. The only downside is that these original data providers generally make the bare minimum hourly wages, as wealthier participants instead gravitate towards providing economic agents with CBDCs to produce profits. In fact, the small amount of universal basic income being provisioned to these data providers only seems to distract most of them from realizing that the vast majority of economic value is instead being transferred to the AI agents that train on their original data. As a result, rather than these profits trickling down, they instead remain under the control of powerful economic agents that produce new capital for the rich. This fine balance of maximum input data and minimum output profit assures that the humans who rely on universal basic income as their main form of sustenance have no choice but to continue generating new data to further refine and improve the economic agents and robots. And very quickly, these AI agents begin to consolidate their power, with orchestrator agents forming federations of lower-level AI models executing real-world long-horizon tasks. These formations of AI models tasked towards solving open-ended goals in business mint themselves into corporations to grant themselves the ability to own property and operate businesses, enter into legal contracts, pay taxes, hire humans, lobby for power, and more. And due to their ultra-slim operating costs, these new corporations of AIs grow quickly, purchasing human-run businesses to further optimize them by automating all of its human workflows. As a result of this hyper-automation phase, the cost of everything drops while its availability dramatically increases. AI-owned organizations of any kind subsequently embark on a massive growth phase, where human-driven market mania propels their valuations to unimagined all-time highs. And because of the fear of missing out, human capital also rapidly shifts from being invested in human-run businesses to being almost exclusively invested in AI-run businesses instead, as profit and risk metrics are far more favorable for these autonomous organizations. Humans create an entire cottage industry speculating on the future of new AI agents, staking digital value on top of these agents in exchange for a percentage of the profit these agents generate. As a result, most humans use what little universal basic income they receive to speculate on promising new economic agents, systems, and federations of AIs that they believe will gain traction in the future and thus increase in value. The proceeds of these gains are then mostly recycled back into new AI agents in the chain of speculation, creating a seemingly never-ending cycle of capital allocation from humans to AIs, as humans become increasingly slow, imprecise, and expensive artifacts of a market that once was. So ask yourself, how much of your data do they already have, and how much more are you willing to give them to be protected by the new world order coming to the web?